Here's a Beyond the Pitch podcast quick hit from the WVSA Digital Network.
Oh, goodness. Yes, you did hit a button with me. I am the nap champ, and I always have that tagline. There was this study that came out, and the media kind of ran away with it, saying, you know, naps aren't good for you. They don't do much for you. But when you look at the study in detail, you see that they did a 30-minute nap during the night as a substitute for a normal night's sleep, along with a 60-minute nap at night. And usually when we define naps, we define it as daytime sleep. So it was a bit misleading. And, you know, the conclusion was a 30-minute nap at night or a 60-minute nap at night does not improve your performance the following day. And I mean, that seems pretty obvious. You can't substitute an hour of sleep for the 7, 8, 9 hours you should be getting as an adolescent. So naps, in my opinion, are amazing for athletes. And it is a big opportunity because not a lot of athletes are napping. And so it's a way to make up for some of that lost sleep, you know, potentially across the week. Or if you're, for example, a swimmer, you have early morning, obviously that's not your audience, but maybe there's some early morning training going on, some early morning strength training, where a nap could be really beneficial to help make up for that lost nighttime sleep. But also it will help improve your performance, even if you are getting a good amount of nighttime sleep. Adding in a 10, 15, 20 minute nap is going to make you perform better. It's going to make you more alert. It's going to boost your mood. So any chance you can get to kind of fit that in, whether that be, you know, maybe even right after school or right after practice, any chance you can get that in. The one thing you want to be aware of is you don't want it to impact your nighttime sleep. So, you know, you don't want to take a 2-hour nap or a 3-hour nap too close to bedtime. But if you keep that nap short, that will help you still be able to fall asleep at night.